This video is sponsored by WingWing Technology, your ultimate fly sim hardware solution.
Featuring the Orion Hotas, current and future configurations.
Hello everyone, I hope you're all doing very well. Today we're looking at the maximum kinematic range of the various missiles. And you guys have asked me to try out the Russian extended range medium range missile, the R-27ER. That's a FOX-1 semi-active radar homing missile. Here is the chart as it stands. PL-15 China long-range missile in the lead, followed by the American AIM-120D, then the R-37 Russian long-range missile, AIM-54A back from the 70s, European Meteor, and then the first medium-range missile, the AIM-120C5. It shows the type, FOX-3, all of them, the range achieved from the point of firing the missile to where the hostile is at that point of firing. That's how we're measuring this. Some of you disagree with the method, but that's how we've done everything so far. And we've got the limiting factor for each of the type of missile. Some are battery life, some are kinematics and drag, some are radar lock, some are radar display. Now the interesting thing about this is the first FOX-1, the semi-active radar guided missile, that we've tried. And so it's going to be interesting to see what kind of dynamics we're going to find. If you don't know what I'm talking about, that is the one. I'm sure you've all seen that before. In terms of today's test, we've set everything up absolutely optimally. We are in a MiG-29 Alpha, the lightest, fastest variant of the MiG-29. It's the fastest and highest I can launch this missile from without cheating. I could go to the Su-57 and fly at 150,000 feet, but it's just cheating and unrealistic. So let's try and keep roughly within realism. I'm going a Mach 2.3 at just under 60,000 feet. The guy I'm firing at is an A380 drone with no people in it. It's traveling at 40,000 feet, Mach 0.72. So everything is absolutely topped out as usual. I've already done this test and I can tell you it's a weird result, but I need to show you guys. So let me reset and let's get going. Okay, so off we go. And we need to fly this thing manually because autopilot won't actually hold it up here.
Fuel 500. So.
Bit of a pig to fly this thing.
Bingo fuel.
Okay, got that level set. Afterburners on. Missile selected. There's the target. All right, we get as high as we can to thinnest air we possibly can. Now we're going to wait until we get to R maximum. That's the maximum legal range that we can launch the missile. If you know what I'm talking about, it is when that arrow meets that line there. So I'm going to speed up a little bit here. Don't want to lose any altitude. Let's go up again a bit. And we're about to hit R max. Prepare to fire. Push and hold. Push and hold.
Launch.
Push and hold. Missile out. Time of firing. We are near as damn it. It's 48 nautical miles. We're going to follow the missile and check we hit now. Unlike the other missiles, we have to gain a radar or keep a radar lock all the way until impact, which is the type of missile this is. It has various advantages and disadvantages for that fact. Now, interestingly, this missile has not lofted, whereas all of the FOX-3 variants lofted. So it's never going to be as kinematically optimal for long range. It is very fast, though. If you saw the figures, watching the figures on the bottom of the screen, it was a very fast missile. Thunking great warhead on that missile. So we achieved their kinematic maximum of 48 nautical miles. Now, the natural thing at this point is to redo it, of course, is what you'll all be saying, and fire it outside of the launch authorization and see what happens. So let's go and do that.
Fuel 1500.
So let's fire it not far, just a little bit outside of its official envelope. Let's say there. So that there is our max. That is where we actually are. It is 55 miles, so just 7 miles further, not very far. Blink of an eye. I've overridden the launch authorization. Let's fire the missile. Same altitude, same speed. Let's just get settled with the trim. Note again, it's not lofting. And watch the very curious thing that happens. Again, I get to check the speed a bit better now. So well over 3,500 knots. That's a very, very fast missile, 50-odd thousand feet. Just got to maintain the lock. Can't get the autopilot working at the moment, which is why I have to keep switching around. Right, watch this very curious anomaly. So, just to prove I've still got radar lock and everything is legal, check radar lock, everything is legal. Ping. What happens is, at the travelled distance of the RMX, that's 48 nautical miles, as you saw, it just turns itself off. I'm assuming it's running out of battery at that point. It just loses seeker and whee, flies by and no effect. So my best guess is at the RMX, it runs out of battery, it turns itself off, it goes dumb and it just goes into the sea. Because kinematically, it's still extremely strong. It's got 1,500 knots. This thing could go for another 20 plus miles. If it lofted, it could go for probably another 50 miles or so. If you think there's another reason why it's doing this, please let me know. But I've double-checked, triple-checked all different ranges. Double-checked we've got the lock. And that's just what seems to happen. So, as it stands, for reasons that I don't understand, and we can't force this thing to loft, by the way, either. It does what it wants to do. Even if I aim it up into the air, it's still gonna come straight down and go flat, if you know what I mean. So let me know your thoughts on that. But the weakest by far in the group is R-27ER, a semi-active radar homing missile with a range of 48 nautical miles, and we think probably it seems to be the battery life that's terminating the shot. So very weak, but that's how it is. I hope you enjoyed it otherwise, and see you later.